George Gascón was sworn in as the district attorney of the city of Los Angeles on Monday of this week. That would be yesterday. Now, if you've not heard that name, you should know that Gascón is best known for destroying the city of San Francisco. He was the district attorney there for 8 years, from 2011 to 2019. Under his tenure, San Francisco led the state of California in property crimes and violent crimes, but ranked near the bottom in arrests. Now, you might be wondering, with someone with a track record like that, how that person could move up and become DA in Los Angeles, or anywhere for that matter. And the answer, of course, is that he had powerful help. Gascón's campaign received millions of dollars from George Soros and other left-wing donors, people who don't live anywhere near the communities he plans to destroy. And he does plan to. Immediately after his swearing in on Monday, Gascón made it clear he's going to do what he did to San Francisco to Los Angeles. He declared that prosecutors will not pursue most cases of, among other things, trespassing, drug possession, disturbing the peace, resisting arrest. Here's how he broke the news.
And we criminalize behavior largely associated with poverty. Loitering, drinking in public, public intoxication, possession of drugs and paraphernalia, and more.
Mm-hmm. So poor people just can't help themselves. They loiter, they're drunk in public, they have to commit crimes, they resist arrest, violent crimes. They're poor, so this is what they do. That's insulting, of course, but it's also the beginning of the end of society itself. When you tell people they're allowed to resist arrest, what are you saying? Well, of course, you're saying that the police have no right to stop crime. What happens then? Not enough, Gascón believes. Bail itself has to be eliminated. Watch this.
My office will roll out a plan to end money bail in Los Angeles in its entirety. We will be the largest office in the nation to eliminate cash bail.
Uh-huh. And not just cash bail, and not just decriminalizing resisting arrest and public drunkenness, but the death penalty. Needless to say, that's racist too.
Racism and the death penalty in our country are inextricably intertwined. The reality is that the death penalty does not make us safer. It is racist, and beginning today, it's off the table in LA County.